In a previous video, I have explained to you about the definition of respiration. To recall your memory, I will repeat the same definition once again. Respiration is process of biochemical process of oxidation of organic food to liberate chemical energy. Here, glucose is oxidized to liberate 38 ATP molecules of energy, as well as at the same time, some byproducts are formed there, such as carbon dioxide and water vapors. For respiration, exchange of gases between organism and environment, it should be there. For that purpose, the respiratory organs in case of different living organisms are different one. Such as, for example, the respiratory organs in case of plants, they are different than the animals. In case of flowering terrestrial plants, the stomata is a respiratory organ. In case of woody plants, that is particularly in trees and shrubs, lenticels are there, which are used as a respiratory organ. In case of animals, there is a wide variety of respiratory organs. In lower category animals, which animals are not having well organized system, the organs for respiration are different one. In higher category animals, the organs of respiration are different one. So you have to study about the respiratory organs in different animals by using this chart. I'm now going to discuss about this chart as well as some additional examples. I will tell you some additional examples in that particular class or in that particular phylum having the different type of respiratory organ. आता यामध्ये तुम्हाला कसं बघायचं बघा की हे रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन आणि ऑर्गॅनिझम हे लक्षात ठेवण्यासाठी कारण याच्यामध्ये एखादं एक्झाम्पल तुम्हाला नीटमध्ये किंवा सीईटीमध्ये फक्त एक्झाम्पल्स दिले जातं आणि त्याचं रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन विचारलं जातं त्यामुळे एखादं एक्झाम्पल कोणत्या क्लासमध्ये येतं किंवा कोणत्या फायलममध्ये येतं याची माहिती तुम्हाला असणं आवश्यक आहे मग ही माहिती घेण्यासाठी तुम्हाला अकरावीतल्या क्लासिफिकेशन या टॉपिककडे थोडं जावं लागेल की ज्यामध्ये आपण क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ॲनिमल हा जो टॉपिक शिकला त्याच्यामध्ये क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ इनव्हर्टिब्रेट ॲनिमल्स किंवा नॉन कॉर्डेट ॲनिमल्स अँड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कॉर्डेट ॲनिमल्स याचे जर तुम्हाला सगळे फायलम आणि क्लासेस लक्षात असतील तर त्या पद्धतीने जर तुम्ही हा चार्ट लक्षात ठेवला तरी चालेल फॉर एक्झाम्पल इन किंगडम प्रोटीस Particularly in kingdom protists, the unicellular organisms are there, such as amoeba, paramecium. They are single-celled organisms using their cell membrane or the plasma membrane for exchange of gases or for the purpose of respiration. In case of sponges, where these animals they are having cell aggregate pattern, but well-organized system is not there, well-developed organ is not there. Because of that, in case of sponges also. The plasma membrane or the cell membrane is used as a respiratory organ. In coelenterates, particularly in case of coelenterates, hydra, sea anemone, jellyfish-like animals are included there. They are also using the plasma membrane for exchange of gases, that is oxygen and carbon dioxide. Then nextly, the next phylum that is platelmints. The example it is here, planaria. Planaria like flatworms. They are having again the plasma membrane or general body surface they use for exchange of gases. Next phylum it is here that is annelida. In annelida animal the example that is nereis or in earthworm and in case of leech also general body surface or moist skin it is used for respiration purpose. In case of arthropodan animal in arthropoda. A class insect is there. Some insects which are terrestrial one, they are living on land. The land living insects, they have trachea and spiracles as a respiratory organs. But the aquatic insects, they use the different organ that is book gills. They are used by aquatic arthropodan animals. And spider and scorpion like arthropodan animal, they have special respiratory organs such as book lungs. So book lungs, they are used by spider and scorpion. Other insects, for example, butterfly, grasshopper and etc. They are using the trachea and the spiracle for respiration. And aquatic arthropodan animals such as prawn or crab, they are using book gills as a respiratory organ. Now the vertebrate animals, in case of vertebrate animal, the pisces, class Pisces, that is fishes, they are having internal gills for respiration. Reptiles, birds and mammals using lungs as a respiratory organ. And in case of turtle, special type of respiratory organ it is there, that is cloaca, it is used for respiration. So in different animal, different type of respiratory organs they are used. In man, a special respiratory organs, they are paired lungs. So paired lungs are the organs of respiration in case of man. That's why the respiratory system in man, it is known as here pulmonary respiration. Pulmonary respiration, it is observed in case of man. Now I am going to start with the respiratory system of man. A respiratory system of man, which mainly consists of respiratory passage and the paired lungs. So the system, it is divisible into two different parts, that is the respiratory passage and the paired lungs. The respiratory passage, it is again divisible into two different regions, that is upper respiratory passage and the lower respiratory passage. Upper respiratory passage consists of nodes, that is paired nostrils, nasal chamber, then the pharynx and larynx, they are included in upper respiratory passage. And the remaining part, that is the trachea, bronchi, bronchioles, they are included in the lower respiratory passage. So now I am going to start with each and every part of the respiratory system, that is the location of that part, about the structure of that part and the function of that part. Now first part of the respiratory system, that is the nodes. Nodes, at the tip of nodes, paired openings are present there, which are known as here external nares or nostrils. A paired nostrils, they are present at the tip of nose. The main function of that is intaking of air containing a large amount of oxygen. Now the nose it is divisible into two different chambers, that is nasal chambers, by a median cartilage bone, that is a mesethmoid. So mesethmoid is a cartilaginous bone which divide the nasal passage or nasal cavity into right and left halves. Sometimes the question may be asked here for CET or for MCQ question. The question is there, that is which bone divide the nasal cavity into right and left lobes. So the answer is here mesethmoid bone. So that mesethmoid is a cartilaginous bone present at the median region of the nose, divide the nasal passage into right and left parts. Now the external nostrils get open into a nasal chamber or nasal cavity, that is right and left nasal chambers or the cavities, which are again divisible into different regions, that is anterior most part, which is a nearest to the external nostril, that is known as vestibular part, then middle part of the nasal chamber, that is a respiratory part, and a posterior part of the nasal chamber, that is sensory part. Now the vestibular chamber. The vestibular chamber, it is anterior part, internally it is lined by hairs. The main purpose of that part, that is to trap the dust particle and avoid entry of dust particle inside the lungs. The next part, that is here respiratory part, the respiratory part which is internally covered by large number of blood capillaries. So that blood capillaries and that part, that is the respiratory part which moisten the air, which make the air warm which is entering inside the lungs. And the posterior most part, that is the sensory part, which is internally lined by sensory epithelium. In that part, it is mainly for the purpose of detection of the smell. So nasal chamber is again divisible into three different regions, that is vestibular part, anterior most part of the nasal chamber, middle part, that is respiratory part, and a posterior most part, that is a sensory part. Now this nasal chamber, it opens into here pharynx or in throat. Pharynx is a common passage. It is a wide tube. It is common passage for food and air, which is further divided into different regions, that is oropharynx, laryngopharynx. Such type of different parts they are observed here in pharynx. So pharynx, it is common passage for food and air. And at the base of pharynx, there are two different openings. One is gullate and next opening, that is a glottis. Glottis, it is opening of the trachea here. And gullet, that is opening of esophagus, which is present at anterior part of the trachea, which is present backside to the trachea, and gullet, that is opening of the trachea. Such two different openings are present at the base of the pharynx. So that pharynx, it is common passage for food and air. Now the pharynx, it opens into a wide tube-like structure, that is a larynx. Larynx, which is also known as Adam's apple. Why it is known as Adam's apple? Because in case of males particularly, larynx, it is broader one, it is larger one than the female. And in case of male, at the time of puberty or during the puberty, it becomes enlarged, which we can observe through neck region also externally. And that swollen part, which is observed in neck region, that's why it is known as Adam's apple. Larynx, it is a sound producing box. Internally, it is lined by vocal cords. At the time of entering of air, the vocal cords vibrate there and produce sound. Because of that, it is sound producing box. In addition to carry the air, it also performs the function of sound production. So it is a dual organ that is performing both functions. Dual organ performing both functions, that is to produce sound and to carry the air. Larynx now opens into trachea. Trachea is a windpipe. It is measuring about 10 to 12 centimeter in length. It passes through our neck region and enters into the thoracic cavity in thoracic region. Further, it divides into two different branches, which are known as your bronchi. Each bronchus enters into a respective lung. Trachea is externally lined by C-shaped cartilage rings. These C-shaped cartilage rings, they are about 16 to 20 in number in an adult person. These rings keep the trachea wedge open. They avoid collapsing of the trachea. As well as the trachea, it is internally lined by mucus secreting gland cells. In addition to that, ciliated epithelial cells are also lined in the inner wall of trachea. Because of that, the dust particles which are entering through mouth towards the trachea, they are trapped here by using the mucus, and with help of ciliated epithelium, they are pushed back towards the throat. So the trachea, it performs different functions, that is, it carries air as well as that it carries air containing oxygen towards the lungs, as well as trachea also trap the dust particles which are entering through mouth. Trachea can trap the dust particles because in wall of trachea, the mucus secreting cells are present there, which secrete mucus. The dust particles get attached to that mucus. And the ciliated epithelial cells, the cilia of those cells, they are used to sweep the dust particles towards the throat. And that's why the trachea performing different functions, that is to carry the air containing oxygen, to trap the dust particle and push the dust particle towards the throat. Now, nextly, the trachea further divided into two different branches after entering into the thoracic cavity. These two different branches, they are known as your bronchi. Each one, that is a right and left bronchus. The bronchi are also lined by C-shaped cartilage rings. And main purpose of that C-shaped cartilage ring is to keep the trachea always open, to avoid the collapsing of the trachea. That is the main purpose of the C-shaped cartilage rings. Bronchi, they are also lined by such C-shaped cartilage rings. The right and left bronchus, after entering inside the lung, they further divided into different branches, that is primary bronchus, secondary bronchus, and a tertiary bronchus. Now, tertiary bronchus finally terminate into small branches, that is bronchioles, which are further opens into the last part, that is alveoli or air sacs. The alveoli or air sacs in each lung, there are about 730 million alveoli or air sacs are there. These air sacs or alveoli, they are arranged as like the bunch of grapes. Each alveolus is circular, it is very thin walled, lined by single layer, and each alveolus is richly supplied by blood capillaries. Because exchange of gases particularly takes place between the blood and the alveolus. So that alveolus, it is very thin walled, having single layer, and it is richly supplied by blood vessel. Such type of group of alveoli or bunch, grape-like bunch, it is present in each lung, and in each lung there are about 730 million such alveoli are present there, which provide more and more surface area for exchange of gases. So the respiratory passage made by these different parts. Now observe once again the respiratory passage, how it starts there. It starts with paired nostrils, that paired openings present at tip of nose. Through that nostrils, air containing oxygen enters inside. These nostrils get open into nasal chamber. Nasal chamber, which is further divided into different regions, such as vestibular part, then the respiratory part, and the sensory part. A nasal chamber also performing the function of filtration of air. Air enters through nose, get filtered, and afterwards it is passed towards the lungs. So it is one of the filtration of air. Nextly, that nasal chambers open into pharynx, which is a common passage for food and air, as well as at the base of pharynx, the lymphoid tissue is there, that is known as tonsils. Tonsils, they are particularly useful for production of lymphocytes, so that they are also performing the function of immunity development. Here in respiratory system, throat performing the function to carry the air towards the larynx and afterwards towards the trachea. But in throat, there are, at the base of throat, two openings are there. One is known as glottis, that is opening of trachea, and next one is a gullet, that is opening for food, that is opening of esophagus. So throat performing both function to carry air as well as to carry the food. That glottis, it is covered by a lid-like structure known as epiglottis. That epiglottis, which perform the function of preventing entry of food as well as water at the time of swallowing food and drinking the water. So epiglottis, it is present there, which cover the glottis. Now the pharynx get opens into a larynx. Larynx is a sound producing box. It is also known as Adam's apple because it is enlarged during the time of puberty and can be observed externally through neck in case of males particularly. That's why it is known as Adam's apple. It is a dual organ because it carry air as well as produce sound. Larynx internally, it is lined by a cords of cartilage, that is vocal cords. Larynx get open into trachea. Trachea is a windpipe which is measuring about 10 to 12 centimeter in length. It passes through our neck region and then afterwards it enters in thoracic region and get further divided into two branches, that is bronchi. Each bronchus enters into that respective lung. Trachea externally lined by C-shaped cartilage rings. There are about 16 to 20 in number in an adult person. These C-shaped cartilage rings keeping the trachea always open, avoid collapsing of the trachea. Trachea perform the function to carry the air towards lungs, as well as internally it is lined by mucus secreting gland cells. Next, it is also lined by the ciliated epithelium. So the dust particles which are entering through mouth, they get trapped here by using the mucus. And these trapped particles, these are pushed towards the pharynx back with help of movement of cilia. present in ciliated epithelium. So the trachea performing different functions here. Now the trachea get further divided into different branches, that is bronchi. Each one is a bronchus, right and left bronchus. Bronchi are also lined by C-shaped cartilage rings to keep the each bronchus open. They are also lined by the C-shaped cartilage rings. After entering inside lung, each bronchus further divided into primary, secondary, and the tertiary branches. Primary bronchus, secondary bronchus, and tertiary bronchus, these are the branches. Tertiary bronchus further, divided into minute branches known as bronchioles, and bronchioles get open into air sacs. Now the air sacs, these are arranged in groups as like bunch of grapes. Each air sac, it is rounded in shape, measuring about 0.1 millimeter in diameter, and each air sac, it is lined by blood capillaries. Air sacs, there are about 730 million air sacs that are present in each lung, and it is richly supplied by blood capillaries. Air sacs or alveoli, they provide most of the area for exchange of gases. They provide surface for exchange of gases, and exchange of gases between blood and alveolus, it is completed inside the air sacs or inside the alveoli. So these different parts, they are included in respiratory passage. Now next part of respiratory system of man, they are paired lungs. Lungs, they are bluish in color. They are elastic, sac-like structures, conical structures. They are spongy one. They are externally covered by a membrane, double membrane, that is a pleural membrane, the outer membrane and the inner membrane, that is pleural membrane, that is parietal membrane and visceral membranes are there. In between these two membranes, there is a pleural space, that pleural space filled by pleural fluid. This pleural membrane mainly performing the function of protection of lungs. The pleural fluid, that is useful to avoid friction between between the lungs and different organs. Now the right lung, it is larger in size than the left lung. Right lung having three lobes. Left lung is smaller than right one, and it is divided into two lobes. Lungs, they are main organs of respiration in man. So in this manner, I have completed here human respiratory system, which consists of respiratory passage and paired lungs.